Hey guys, today's story is about an OP who had to kick a longtime friend for being toxic. This is my first post in the sub, but I enjoy reading and learning from all the stories posted here. I'm mostly sharing my own story to get it out and hopefully get some therapeutic closure out of it, and out of a need to be told by outsiders that I did the right thing. So, about 5 years ago, my friends and I started up a 3-5 game, and one of my best buds DM'd it, and it's our longest running game still. It's had its ups and downs, as you'd expect from a baby's first game. We've started several other games, now Pathfinder up alongside it, and I DM one of them, and a friend another. But the heart of these groups, two friends and I, have been the core of it. The focus of the story is the initial DM, who I'll just call that. As the few years went on, the initial DM went through a bad breakup with one of our players, and eventually we just determined it was best to kick her from the games because tensions were just too high between the two of them. Our friend group slowly expanded, and a new girl came along who also joined the games. She and the DM carried on a semi-toxic romance that eventually imploded with the DM harassing her, which our whole friend group confronted him over it. We let him know that it wasn't cool, and he had to work on himself so we could still be friends. Shortly after this, he had to leave for a trip, so it was a convenient time to provide everyone some breathing room from his antics, and hopefully reconvene when he returned. And we did when he got back. However, there was still tensions between the DM and the girl. However, at that point, we were mostly playing my game, and right off the bat, his character was challenging hers. He had a really big personality that he leaned into when he RP'd, and she was still relatively new to D&D, so she was too intimidated to really get into the headspace of her character. And as time went on, we could easily read his in-game actions as passive-aggressive resentment between them. For example, their first interaction was his strength-based fighter challenging her dex-based swashbuckler to a wrestling match to prove her worth, the result of which you can probably imagine. Her character is also a former slave, and his character comes from a culture that has slaves, and he would occasionally intentionally lean into being insensitive about it, but she would just be too intimidated in character to challenge those views. It should also be noted that she really was the only one who maintained a strong friendship with him outside of the game, even though she was the one who was most hurt by his drama to begin with. The rest of us had pretty good boundaries about keeping him just as a D&D buddy, but her willingness to keep him around in her life outside of the game, and within it, finally wore down her nerves, and with her anxiety, she just decided to up and quit. My original friend and I, the two who asked the initial DM to play, way back when, made it clear to her, if it came down to it, we would choose her over him. Our first game that he DMs had been getting boring, and he was ignoring our desire to get back to the story, and was more interested in meme dungeon crawls than the character-driven narrative we were invested in. You know, those DMs who sort of treat the PCs like their own dolls rather than extensions of the players. So with that in mind, and just generally how uncomfortable with how the girl was feeling, as well as some political opinions that the guy had been expressing, we felt it best to just call it and cut him from the game and quit our first one. It's been a real bummer dealing with it the past few days, and I only just got a reply from him about it all. The dude's been one of my friends for a long time, and he started our D&D journey with us, but it felt like his toxicity, perceived or otherwise, just made me feel like I had a responsibility as a DM myself to get rid of the thing that made another player uncomfortable. I should have addressed it earlier as a group, but the girl sprung the decision on me before I was fully ready to deal with it. I know I'm probably using too many or too little details, but if someone can let me know if they feel like I made the right call, I'd feel better. The group has really been supportive, and it's been a team decision for the most part, but an objective take would go a long way. Otherwise, hopefully you got some lesson out of this. Most notably, the obvious one we see time and time again. Don't date your players unless the relationship is genuinely healthy, because otherwise, you might not get over it. Yikes. Well guys, I have nothing particularly creative or valuable to add on to this, so that's the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed, and if you would like to talk and hang out with other people, I have a Discord link in the description. But, as always, have a good one.